Hello friends, I'm having a very new offering from Mercedes-Benz in India, which is one of their important model and most important model in SUV segment, which has the most number, the GLC. And GLC is gone a facelift, and we are having the latest GLC here. The facelift is gone on the front and the rear mostly, so you can see a new grille treatment. It's more angular, and you have a two slack grille. A new high performance LED light with a double stripe is there, which is playing as a LED daytime running light. And here a new bumper with a chrome, and got a proper SUV kind of feel. Side profile remains the same, but you got a new 19 inch wheel. You can see there's a dirted wheel, so you can see it's actually boulder spoke, but the thin styling look very attractive. The side remains the same with the roof rail step all retained. There's a chrome over the greenhouse. And the rear also design remains the same, but there is a change on the in the cluster of the taillight. It looks more attractive when it illuminates. It's a plain one from outside, but inside you can see a very minimalistic design going in. Once it is illuminated, you'll get that 3D kind of feel. And bumper is also reworked with a chrome finish and a new exhaust design, which has been introduced in the new GLE, which is coming to India very soon. So this is the new GLC. The most important thing about the new GLC is the introduction of MBUX platform. For the first time in India, we'll be seeing more cars coming up with the MBUX, but this is the debuting model. With the facelift, GLC has not undergone a major design changes, but there has been some improvement. One is majorly the screen, which is the MBUX platform, and the touch screen, and it's got a very different graphic, which I'll explain you a little later. There's a new steering wheel, which is more sportier, and it looks very attractive. The switches, all the touch functions, everything is on hand reach, and it's got a new layout. The media console has a different layout for the central screen, which is a TFT screen, and a new control for the MBUX without the rotary knob. It's a touchpad again. Seats, everything remain as such, as the same. The interior has two color options, one is the beige, other one is the black. And the wood panel is not having the glossy finish now, it's a matte finish. There are the changes which has undergone. Otherwise, GLC had a very spacious interior on this segment. It's a very comfortable seat is having. Both the front and the rear seats are good for a long drive. It's best for four adults and one kid. Roominess and the feel of roominess is very high because of the bigger glasses, sunroof and split sunroof. So, GLC remained the same in the interior on design. But the major change or major input is the MBUX platform, which I'll be explaining. MBUX or Mercedes-Benz User Experience is the latest multimedia interface for Mercedes-Benz. It is actually debuting in A-Class in global market, but in India, GLC is the debuting model. So we have the first level of MBUX here in this GLC, and it is controlled on voice, touch, and even on the touch screen control. And there is a gesture function also available in this platform, which is right not available on GLC. So the control on voice is something very attractive. Let's control it like this. Hey Mercedes.
How may I help you?
Change ambient color to blue.
Okay, I am changing the color.
So it's as simple as that. You can control a lot of functions like the color of interior, the navigation, the radio, and even the temperature on this control. Which function as offline, which is an inbuilt function which can be controlled even without having a connection on your SIM or the phone you're connected. There are a few other connections which can be controlled with the phone interface, like, hey Mercedes.
How may I help you?
I'm feeling hungry.
Please select an entry.
So these are the options they are giving, and I can select one of them, and we can be specific also. Hi Mercedes.
How may I help you?
I want to have biryani.
Select a destination by saying the corresponding number, the name or the address.
So these are some of the functions which are available with the MBUX. You can even opt for having a biryani, for example. And you can also interact with the car like your friend or a pal. Like you can ask various questions like, for example, to crack a joke. So if you're asking such a question, car will have funny answers like, so what I got the answer while we were doing the demo was, the developer was a German, so she can't crack a joke. For example, other question like, if you're saying to follow the car, so it will say we are not in a Hollywood movie. So that kind of interactions also happen. But what I really attracted was the kind of acceptance of various dialects. Like, we are having a different dialect from the Europeans, but we tried it with different accents and different sound. Everything is picking up and is very fast. So this interface is very updated, and it is prompt for Indian accent. We tried it very different slangs, so it's been very successful. That's one thing which has been introduced with the new GLC. Other thing is the Mercedes Me app, where you can download the app both on Android and Apple, and you can connect it with the login ID which you'll get when you buy in the car. Once you're connected, you'll get all the functions like the monitoring the car, you can have the chauffeur connection, you can do the valet settings, wherein like on valet mode it won't exceed the speed, and if somebody else is using the car or it is getting unlocked, you'll get the information and lot of other information like the service due, what is the average you maintain, lot of things. So this is a big interface connection. It also get used to by the time you're using the car regularly, it'll understand our habits and regular commutes, and it can set accordingly. All this augmented reality and artificial intelligence work very well with this MBUX. So I would say this is the first stage of MBUX coming to India. We can see more coming up with the future cars coming in the Mercedes table. The new GLC come with two engine options. One is a petrol, 2-liter petrol, which is having an output of 197 HP and 320 Nm of torque. What we are driving right now is a diesel. It's a 2-liter again, 4-cylinder one with 194 HP power and 400 Nm of torque. Both engines are mated to a 9-speed gearbox, which is a very smooth, refined gearbox. So it shift gears which is not required and go to higher gear, giving out more fuel efficiency. And the gear changing is very smooth. It's also having 4MATIC 4-wheel drive system, and it's good for mild off-roading, not for the hardcore off-roading. But what really lagged about the powertrain is the refinement level, which has improved a lot. You don't feel the engine inside the cabin, even though outside is a bit noisy. The NVS level has improved a lot. Suspension also plays a big role, and it's not having that harshness. The suspension is smooth and good for long drive. It can float well on highways, and even on the bad patch of road, it can glide over. Steering is also responsive, it's a speed sensitive one, and the response level is also very good. So what really matters about the new GLC is basically the new MBUX platform, which is a breakthrough for Mercedes-Benz in the multimedia system. So this is the first drive of the all new GLC. You can check out our YouTube channel for an elaborated review.